Happy Wednesday, B-Fam! Can you believe a month has already gone by? Most people see January as a time to make changes, but it can also be a tough month for those still struggling to move forward. This is your reminder to take it easy because you still have the rest of the year to make yourself better. Of course, join me, your main girl, Shania Gomez, as we heal and beat the January blues. Only here on The Place to Be happy, be you, BRGY. There are a number of ways to heal, from expressing your emotions to simply reaching out to a friend. We all have our own unique methods, but I think art can be a powerful tool for promoting healing and wellness. Viewing and creating art can elicit emotions, spark creativity, and provide a sense of connection and belonging. Most of all, it can be used to process and communicate complex feelings and experiences. Today, we are sharing three in-real-life stories of healing through art. Let's start our throwback kwentuhan with this G-Pinoy from Riyadh, Saudi Arabia, who achieved success as a flight attendant and a painter. Here is our first best of IRL.
Hello po, ako si Stefi Laron. Ako po ay 32 years old. Ako po ay isang flight attendant and artist dito sa Riyadh, Saudi Arabia. Ako po ay nagstay dito sa Saudi Arabia when I was 1 year old pa lang. So yung parents ko po ay nagtatrabaho dito sa Riyadh. My father was an engineer sa Khamis Mashayt and yung mama ko po ay isang nurse. At dito na rin po sila nagkakilala. Tapos dito na rin nag-start ng family. Tapos po, nagkaroon po ng pagkakataon na magkatrabaho po ako dito sa Riyadh. Napunta po ako dito noong 2013. So, yun na po yung job ko noon and hanggang ngayon po, I've been with them for 9 years. So, I took up tourism and hospitality management sa Pilipinas. And isa po sa mga career choices ko is maging flight attendant. Sumubok din po ako mag-apply sa Pilipinas. Pero siguro dito yung fate ko. At syempre, hindi ganun kadali. Pero siguro God's will talaga kasi I remember nung nag-apply ako, after 1 year, tinawagan ako. Exactly 1 year, tapos birthday ko pa. Tapos sinabi nila na I got the job. I have been doing art since I was a child. Sabi ng parents ko na nagdo-drawing daw ako kung saan-saan. Makakakuha lang daw ako ng papel at ballpen or lapis. Kahit daw pader dinodrawingan ko. So nakita ng parents ko yung potential ko since then. And unti-unti nila akong binibilhan ng mga art supplies. Tapos, nakita talaga nila na meron akong talent for that. Pero nag-stop ako kasi nagkaroon tayo ng, syempre, ng different interest until, I would say, nung pandemic, nung 2020, nung lahat tayo naka-lockdown. Siguro dahil maraming time, tapos meron na akong space na kung saan magagawa ko yung art ko, nagsimula ako mag-paint uli. And tinry ko lang siyang i-post sa social media. Tapos noon, maraming nakapansin at hindi ko alam na isa sa makakapansin is yung mga art curators dito sa Riyadh and ganun din sa ibang bansa. Tapos doon na po nagsimula yung mga invitations ko for exhibits at saka mga ibang features. My first one was here in Riyadh. It's for, I believe, Mauhub exhibit. And then afterwards po, nagkaroon po ako ng feature sa isang digital art gallery sa Milan, Italy. Tapos po, meron din po isang courtesy call for the Philippine Embassy. And I would say, this is one of my most memorable art exhibits kasi nirepresent po natin yung Pilipinas dito sa Riyadh. Nagkaroon po tayo ng mga guests na mga consul and ambassadors kasi sa diplomatic quarters po siya ginawa. At nakakataba lang po ng puso dahil nakilala po tayo on another part of what we can do as Filipinos. So, naglaan po talaga ako ng designated space para sa aking kumbaga creative time. Gusto ko po na not only do I do my job, but I also cultivate my hobbies and my passion. So, how do I create concept? Honestly, bigla na lang po talaga siya nagpa-pop out. But for me, I like to create art that speaks to my personal experiences. Kumbaga, that's my personal touch po sa aking mga gawa is it has a meaning behind it. And most of the time, ako lang yung nakakaalam. But I let my audience engage. Parang, what's your version of my art? I let them do that. But at the same time, I keep that little secret to me. Why did I paint that? Sino yung person behind it? Ano yung moment behind it? It's a painting of my father, my late father, and my mom. Nung sila po ay nag-renewal of vows. So I think this was 5 years ago, and this is also my first time doing oil. And hindi ko po alam paano ko na-execute kasi medyo nahihirapan po ako nung time na yon. I don't think I'm going to be able to finish it, pero siguro my dad was guiding me, kaya natapos ko po siya. So ito po yung, I guess, my latest finished artwork. The title of this one is Compounding Interest. For me, this is a bit political, pero like I've said earlier, everyone has their own interpretation to it, pero kita naman po natin, baga, in this world, corruption. Matanda na pero meron pa ring mga nagpapabigat sa kanila. And a lot of these things are very small things. So, itong mga to, junk food, they're not as valuable as gold or houses, properties. Pero it does weigh on you. And kahit matanda ka na, it still weighs on you. Art is something meditative. Hindi lang po siyang basta nailagay mo sa medium mo and tapos na. So people appreciate art kasi para po siyang somehow connection between the viewer and the art. Meron pong hindi maipaliwanag na connection between it. Eh. So yun din po yung isa sa reasons bakit binibili minsan ng isang painting or isang artwork kasi meron kang connection between that piece. For me, I would say, number one, do it for yourself and don't do it for the audience or the reward. At the end of the day, it's about your satisfaction and fulfilling your passion. And second po, I think it's very important po for us as Filipinos here abroad is to cultivate your own identity. Kumbaga, napakarami po nating talento na kumbaga very Filipino, very inspired from the Philippines. And yun po yung magiging edge natin eh.
Sometimes a simple childhood hobby and interest can turn into a career. Today, Steffi continues her work as a flight attendant and a painter. At Balita Namin, she recently got invited to another exhibition in Spain. Keep doing wonders, Steffi. We are so, so proud of you. When we return, dalawang creative G-Pinoy stories pa ang babalikan natin. Let's discover the beauty of content creation and multimedia art. Of course, when BRGY returns.
Hello guys, nandito kami ngayon sa holding area. At yun, exciting. Labit na kami mag-performance ko.
Knowing
that you guys are about to perform for next live.
Parang hindi pa siya nagsisink yun nung bagong gising. And tapos nung narealize ko lang siya nung pagpasok ko dyan actually sa yung bumungad yung big studios. Parang, oh my god, ito na pala yun. Parang nandito na tayo sa lagi natin nakikita sa TV or sa YouTube. All I hate.